Just me and Owl here now. Stuck on this platform. Sparrow took the boat. I can't figure out why. Everything is just so secretive. I mean, I don't even know their real names. I only know the team at Selim got a prototype working and they needed more people. We were supposed to be those people. Together, we would find a way out of this mess. Somehow.
Owl's yelling up in the tower. Or maybe the radio picked up something. Is it you, Sparrow?
Owl's radio notes. 22nd of December. Distress call received. Balboa Island. 9th of January. Koku won't accept facts. 2nd of February. Gunshots in the distance. Tangaroa City. 14th of February. Sparrows calm. At Selim. 6th of March. Another distress call. Varuna Point. Missing child. 16th of April. Rafters dreaming of utopia. Foolish hope.
February. We've picked up a lot of signals. Maybe someone will come and help us. We're not starving. Yet. The reactor at Selim might be the only chance we have against this endless ocean. You knew it, Sparrow. Owl thinks you betrayed us, but you must have had a good reason for leaving us here. I hope you make it to Selim. I hope you finish the reactor. For all of us.
Friendly face. Wondering how I ended up here? Long story. Really, really long story.
Anyway, nice raft. If you need any repairs done, let me know.
I've sort of ended up as a maritime expert, mainly due to the world sinking. Awesome. Let's head out. friendly face.
Long story. Really, really long story.
Anyway, nice wrap. If you need any repairs done, let me know.
I've sort of ended up as a maritime expert, mainly due to the world sinking. Awesome. Let's head out.
Heard from the captain, we're heading for one of the high rises down south. I can only hope you come to your senses and follow us. You knew the city was a failure, Ruben. Why do you always have to be so stubborn? Ruben, the yacht is ill-prepared for this journey. Olaf left space for a dance floor, but no space for supplies.
The bottles sure found their way to the bar.
As a military man, I thought Olaf would at the very least be practical. Yet they're all treating it like a luxury cruise. Sorry, Ruben. I shouldn't have left.
As I've suspected, the crew is completely incompetent. Now they're claiming rats have eaten half of our supplies in a matter of weeks. I promised them increased rations if they could bring me one of these ridiculous lurkers alive. Of course, the food shortage will need to be handled. Tonight, we're discussing which staff members are most suitable for termination.
saw a large rat last night. Unnervingly large. I tried telling the crew we obviously have an infestation among the lockdown supplies. They laughed at me. I miss you, Ruben.
Does it again, he will be reprimanded. The crew doesn't listen to orders. I'm shocked by their undisciplined nature. Somehow, they believe rank and prestige disappeared with Solid Land. No, they will not be allowed to mingle among my esteemed guests, and they will certainly not be allowed further rations. They should be grateful. I am the only reason they are alive.
What does that mean? You can't just fire them. We're out at sea.
Hanna, you were brought to keep the engines running. That is what you...
That's one of those damn rats. What are you doing to it?
Get out! Do your job.
Thank you.
These lurkers have potential. They were clearly once rats, now grown into something much more rabid, yet also smarter. I've already made progress on their training. With food and pain as incentives, I can discipline them. And by sharing their blood, the mutations increase. I wonder if another species would react the same. I've received a transmission from a place called Caravan Town, not far from here. They have an active animal population. No longer do I need this makeshift crew. I will create true soldiers. Loyal soldiers.
the lifeboats! Hurry!
Olaf, you coward!
Watch out!
city's in the blue. Calling the cost of the project's realization borderline criminal and its scope outrageous at least. Despite vocal opposition, the Floating Cities project does not appear to be slowing down anytime soon. According to former General Olof Wiltstrom's latest statement on the issue, we are fully aware of the strain this puts on our people. Nevertheless, our options are becoming increasingly limited. We must pull through this together, or join Stockholm beneath the waves. Wiltstrom refused to comment on the rumors regarding the modification of his personal yacht. When further asked about the Floating City Project's whistleblowers, Olof Wiltstrom chose to terminate the interview. Reaching out to these anonymous sources, we were able to further corroborate his story.
Thank you. Maelstrom, it's urgent! There's mist now! We don't know how far the water's risen! The maps are useless! We need to...
The crew are planning a mutiny, Captain. It is time to act.
A mutiny? They're just trying to stay alive! Are you mad?
I gave you a chance to live. Now we have to protect ourselves from the masses. We will use the lurkers to our advantage.
Oh.